Assalamu alaikum and hello again. Today we will solve the spreadsheet or the Excel question from the year 2018. It's May June session, paper 3-1. As you know, it's ICT 0417. Now it was started by web page, and task 3 was the spreadsheet. So you will find it in page 6, task 3. Now, first of all, the first question is talking about to write in your evidence file these mathematical operators. So I will do it just to show you the. Now, for multiplication, the star. Shift 8, then for division, the slash. After this, the indices or the power, it will be this, shift with 6, and not equal, it will be less than, greater than. Okay. So the operators are done. Good for marks. Now, open the two files, estimator and bricks, the CSV files, in spreadsheet package and examine the contents. Now edit the estimator so it looks like this. It will be merged ABC, bold, big font, same here, but it is smaller than number one, and 3 is cropped. Let's do it here. This. Let's just fix the size here. Now, background gray, bold. This is bigger. Okay, then this should be to the right. And this is already to the left. Now, I have to save it in this style. So, just file, save as. Be careful, it is workbook. And stick to the name. Okay. Okay. Now, place your name, center number, candidate number in the header. Then place automated file name, including file path, to the right in the footer. Okay. Page layout, from page setup you can do it, or from insert text. Now this is header footer. My name, Hadil Yusuf, then GO014, then my candidate number. After this, in the footer, it said in the right section, insert the file name with path and path and file. This means the code for file name with the path in the right in the footer. So I am done. Okay and okay. After this, now for the steps 17 to 20, you may enter test data to help you create your model. Restrict the data in the cell B4 to capital S or capital D. Enter formula in B10 to display single for S and double for D. Now let's do 17. When they say restrict, it means validate. So to make this validation in B4, I will click on B4. In data, I will go to validate. And because it is one of two letters, it will be list. And I have to write capital S, capital D as requested in the question. And in the error alert, I will write only enter S or D. Maybe you can say it is restricted for S or D, whatever, but you have to make it in some good meaning. Now you can just select from S or D. How did I do this drop down menu? Here in the validation, I have found this cell drop down. I like to use it, so keep it just to make it like this. This is the best to eliminate the errors of the data entry time. Now, after this, as we read that in B10, we have to display single or double depending on the B4. So click in here, B10, and let's do it as if statement. If the B4 equal S, then single, else double. Okay, now let's choose here single, so it will be single. Switch to double, it is double. Okay, enter a function in B9 to look up the name of the type of brick using bricks. Okay, first of all, I have to check bricks. I can find that the data is done in vertical way in columns, so I will use the VLOOKUP. Now, to find the brick name, I have to get the brick code. Where can I find here the brick code? If you read, you will find that it is in B7. Please enter brick code, which is the type of a brick chosen. It will be in B7. So, to make the lookup as requested in B9, my lookup value will be in B7. I can just write from now C as the brick code, and here I will do the lookup. This is VLOOKUP, and my lookup value here, B7. My table array will be from A2 to B16, enough. And to look up value 0 because it is exact matching. So for C, it will be children. And if you want to choose H, it will be honey buff. Just to check our work, yes, but make it more professional in capital H. Now, just fix the size and save your work, please. Then, some walls. This is the introduction and the explanation for question 20. Question 20 is 9 marks. Now, let's find out how to do question 20. To calculate number of bricks that will be required, a single skin wall, the following formula is used. Now, they are talking to us that when we say single skin wall, it means one brick thick, and when it is double skin, so it means double, two bricks thick. Now, how to calculate the number of bricks which is required to build a single thick wall or single skin wall? First of all, you have to multiply length by height, then divided by the face area of each brick. After this, if you have double skin, twice as many bricks are needed for double skin. So whatever you have calculated here for the single skin, you have to multiply by 2 if you have double. Then for both double skin and single skin, you have to add extra 10% as some bricks will be damaged. This is the margin of damage. Then extra 50 bricks are added as some will need to be cut. So this is done for both, even it is single or double. At the end you have to work on this, but first of all I have to make this formula of height multiplied by length. Then if it is double, I have to divide by the face area. This result will be multiplied by 2 if I have double face. Now they say enter the formula in B11 to calculate the number of bricks required for the wall. Now you can only buy whole bricks. This means I have to make it as integer number. And because we are talking about a quantity of bricks, when we talk about a quantity of bricks, people, a quantity of buses, taxis, cars, chairs, I have to make it as round up. And because it is whole number, it will be for 0 decimal point. Okay, so we are counting here some total numbers as service or need to make something. So it will be round up and it will be 0 decimal place, because I can't say that I will buy 2 bricks and quarter or half. It will be round up. Okay, now first of all I will do this calculation: length multiplied by height. I will say this length multiplied by height, and the answer will be 0, as you know, because we have no values here. Let's make it as 1 by 1. Then this multiplication should be divided by the surface area. But I don't have anything which is talking about the surface area of the brick here. I should check the other file and I will find this face area of the brick here. So this will indicate that I have to pick this number using the VLOOKUP, the same VLOOKUP, but here it will be for the column number 4. So I will go here and I will make divide by VLOOKUP. If you want to work it from here or to open in the FX. Now what's the value for the lookup? It will be the brick code in B7. My table area will include the brick code to the face area. Then it will be 4 and 0 for the exact match. Now I have length by height. Then it is divided by the number which back from H. Okay, now that was if I have a single brick or single skin. Now I have to ask, is it twice, is it double? So I have to make it as efficient work. I will multiply this by the if statement. If my single, or sorry, the thickness of the wall, if it equals D, then multiply by 2, else multiply by 1, which means don't make any change when you multiply by 1. But you can't leave it empty, because it will back with false, so it will make it as error in your answer. So the answer is multiplied by 2 if it is double, or multiplied by 1 if it is single. Okay, now this is because it is double. Now if you make it as single, yes, it is the half. Okay, now for both double skin and single skin, I have to add the 10%. The best way and the most efficient work to add 10% to any value, you have to multiply this value here, the whole the value. I have to multiply my whole answer by 1.1, which means add 0.1 to the whole, which is the 1, plus the final thing, which is the 50 for the whole number. Now, after this, I have to make the round up. You can make it as this. If you are not confident, you can just cut all of this and paste it in the round up, or you can just write after the equal sign round, and you can pick round up here. Then all your formula is the number. Then I have to add the digit number after 50, add comma, then 0, which means 0 decimal place. I want it as whole number. Okay. Round up. As you see, round up, and all the function between the brackets. Then after 50, I will add comma, and the number of digits will be 0. Then I will close the function round up, and it will round it to 51. As you know, that round up will not ignore any single tiny fraction. It will add to it 1 to make it rounded up to the next number. It will not hold it in the number which is now. Okay, now after this, you have got 9 marks. Save and print the spread showing formula. Landscape row and column headings are displayed fully visible. Formula. First of all, make it fully visible. Now I will go to the print preview in the landscape. Then you can make in the sheet row. And now, did they ask me to make it single page wide? No, but I will try. If I do it in the single page wide, fit sheet to one page, it will be readable. So you can do it like this, or to leave it in two pages, it's up to you. But it is not restricted to make it as single page. Okay, now after this, question 22. Enter the data to build a single skin. So it is single V460. First of all, remove the formula. Fix the size. Make it all visible. It is single and it is V. V640, right? Okay. It has the same result, but I have to be careful about the mark of the accurate or correct data entry. Print this spreadsheet single page. Now it is a restriction. Contents are fully visible, and I have to hide the column and row heading right here because I will lose one mark here. Portrait fit, and here I have to make this Even they did not mention the column and row heading should be hidden. You have to do it. Okay. Then change the model to make it the bin scan height 50 for the same V. This is the bin scan height 50. Okay. That's all. We have done 37 easy marks in this exam. See you in the next exam. Best of luck, my dears.